Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, here to talk a little bit more about how exactly SpaceX lands the first stage of their massive Falcon 9 rockets. Now, previously, we've showed you why they don't use parachutes, and also why they land on land sometimes and on the drone ship other times. Well, today we're going to show you how they use these things that look like giant waffle irons alongside some nitrogen thrusters and the rocket engines themselves to actually steer to a bullseye from over 70 miles in altitude going up to 5,000 miles an hour. We're also going to show you what you're seeing when SpaceX puts this up on their webcasts. Let's get started.
3, 2, 1, 0, and liftoff! 1, 4, 6.
After doing the work of helping loft a payload into orbit, the remaining few minutes of most rocket boosters' life is spent coasting up to its highest point, or apogee, and then falling back to Earth only to be destroyed when it either hits the ground, like they do for China and Russian launches, or as it crashes into the ocean like launches from the United States. In order to successfully recover a booster must do a few things. 1. Land. 2. Don't blow up. With additional bonus points for landing on target. Well, actually, that landing thing is really important. The Falcon 9 often lands on a ship that's roughly the size of a football field in the ocean. If it misses, it's doomed to become a future coral reef at the bottom of the ocean. And if it's landing on land, it has that risk of coming down over populated areas. So that being said, being able to control it on the way down is probably just as important as controlling it on the way up. Before we dive into this, let's take a look and summarize what the first stage of a Falcon 9 booster does after it separates from the second stage. Lucky for us, SpaceX captured some incredible footage of this during NROL 76 on May 1st, 2017. First, the first stage performs a flip maneuver to point itself backwards using cold nitrogen gas thrusters. Then the Falcon 9 lights up 3 of its 9 engines for the boost back burn, which it sometimes omits depending on the mission. Then it deploys its grid fins. Once it starts to hit the dense atmosphere, it lights up those same 3 engines again for its entry burn. As it falls through the atmosphere, it steers itself using grid fins. With less than 30 seconds remaining, the Falcon 9 lights up 1 to 3 of its engines just before deploying the landing legs and coming to a nice, smooth touchdown. They make it look so easy. So let's talk about each of these 3 mechanisms quick. First is the cold nitrogen gas thrusters. The Falcon 9 has 2 pods containing 4 nitrogen thrusters that sit way up on the top on the inner stage portion of the booster. These little thrusters orient the vehicle in the vacuum of space. They also perform the initial flip maneuver, which points the rocket engine's retrograde to start slowing the vehicle down during its boost back burn. You'll see little puffs of nitrogen as it continually hones in on its target. Next is everyone's favorite, grid fins! Grid fins were developed in the 1950s in the Soviet Union. They're a fin that's gridded, or a gridded fin if you will, that fold flat against the fuselage of the rocket, or in most cases, missile. That's right, these are most common on missiles since they can fold up and tuck away, allowing for compact storage of the weapon in a silo or a payload bay. SpaceX certainly isn't the first company to be using grid fins on rockets. Oh no no no, that goes to the Soviet Union, who put grid fins on both their Soyuz and their moon rocket, the N1. Grid fins are the perfect choice for the Falcon 9 since they can be deployed in flight. This allows them to be tucked away and streamlined during the ascent, and then deployed during the descent portion. Lastly, you'll notice the engines of the Falcon 9 gimbling. The engines can pivot several degrees and rather quickly, which can provide a lot of control over the stage. Think of balancing a broomstick. You can not only keep the broom vertical, but you can also apply force horizontally and change your position with only input from the very bottom. Okay, let's take this over to the Kerbal Space Program, where I'm gonna try to land the first stage of a Falcon 9. Okay, so our Falcon 9 is loaded up in Kerbal Space Program. Without further ado, let's take off. 3, 2, 1, liftoff! Oh yeah! Look at those 9 Merlin engines burning bright. Beautiful. Okay, so here's our gravity turn. That means we're gonna be turning it a little more sideways until we're eventually pitched all the way over and making all of our velocity go in the horizontal vector and not just vertically. Okay, main engine cutoff, and here comes stage separation, and there goes that second stage. It's gonna continue going on into orbit while we do our little flip maneuver here with those nitrogen thrusters. And now we're gonna light up 3 of those 9 Merlin engines for that boost back burn. This is going to make us go west instead of east. Boost back burn looks good, engine cutoff. All right, let's pop out those grid fins. This view may look familiar to you. SpaceX uses a view very similar to this. In their webcast, it's looking down from the inner stage of the rocket all the way down the first stage. And you can kind of see the grid fins there. It's a really cool view, but it looks a little confusing in real life. Okay, so we were still going up, and we're about to start falling down now. There's apogee, our highest point. Now we're falling back. We're using those little nitrogen thrusters to orient ourselves perfectly as we get ready for our entry burn. Let me show you what this is. We're gonna pull back a little bit and zoom around, and you can see how we get into this position, and that's about where the camera is. All right, here's our entry burn. We're gonna light up three of those 9 Merlin engines again. All right, getting a little spice on this stage here. This slows the rocket down so it doesn't get obliterated as it goes through the atmosphere. Entry burn's complete. Those grid fins start to have more and more control as we get into the thicker atmosphere. And they just keep aiming that first stage at its target. Whoa, settle down there, Jim John. All right, and here's our landing burn. It's just one engine. Okay, looking good, looking good. Oh, this is it. Landing legs out. Oh, this is looking good. All right, here we go. Oh, yes, touchdown on our very first try. No. So hopefully this gives you a good idea of how SpaceX controls a 15-story rocket that falls from the edge of space. If you have any other questions about how SpaceX lands its rockets or any other questions about rockets in general, leave them in the comments below. Make sure and hit subscribe so you know when I make more fun, funny, and factual content. Also, a big shout out to my Patreon supporters for helping make this and other Everyday Astronaut content possible. If you want to help contribute, please visit patreon.com/everydayastronaut. Thank you. Well, that does it for me. I'm Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, bringing space down to Earth for everyday people.